The X-Men franchise is a peculiar beast because it's probably the only superhero franchise that hasn't been plagued by reboots and remakes and reimaginings. It started off with Bryan Singer's first two X-Men movies, then we had Brett Ratner's X-Men 3, which a lot of people were quite hard on, but I quite enjoyed. And I just said hard on, lol. And then we had X-Men Origins Wolverine, a prequel, starring Hugh Jackman, who'd played Wolverine throughout the films, and this was set before them, and X-Men Origins Wolverine was just terrible. And now we have X-Men First Class, which is another prequel, a prequel to the first two X-Men movies, showing how Professor X and Magneto, played by Patrick Stewart and Ian McKellen, respectively, in the original X-Men films, how their friendship came to be, how they met and how they developed the idea of Charles Xavier's School for Gifted Youngsters. And it's peculiar because this isn't a reboot, it's a prequel that fits into the canon already established by Bryan Singer. Now, it does take some liberties with the continuity, but from the opening shots, which are reused footage from the first X-Men movie, it's clear that this is not a reboot, it's not a remake. It does tie into this franchise. So in this film, Professor X and Magneto are played by James McAvoy and Michael Fassbender, who most people know from Inglourious Basterds. I think this film was originally supposed to be X-Men Origins Magneto, and the first half of it really does focus on Michael Fassbender's character as Eric Lenscher, who becomes Magneto, and it's quite obvious that this was intended to be his film, which was then converted and rewritten into an X-Men First Class movie based on the First Class comic books. And that's not to say it doesn't work, because both the actors, James McAvoy and Michael Fassbender, are fantastic in this movie. And the one wild card, I knew that Michael Fassbender would be good because I'm a big fan of his. I've seen pretty much all of the movies he's been in, including Fish Tank and Hunger, which he's fantastic in, and I think he's a fantastic actor. The only wild card was James McAvoy. I wasn't sure if I could picture him becoming Patrick Stewart's Professor X in the original films, but I have to say that he really pulled it off. So this film's directed by Matthew Vaughn, who last year released Kick-Ass, and really gave the comic book genre a shot in the arm. Kick-Ass was a film that both poked fun and was almost a parody of the superhero genre, while also being an entry into it, and was a fantastic movie, and he manages to bring that sensibility to this film. Now, you have to remember, this is a 20th Century Fox franchise, and not only that, it is a multi-billion dollar franchise, the X-Men movies. They are, you know, world-renowned action movies, which you're not going to get too much artistic liberty with from the directors. There are certain boxes that they're going to have to tick in order for 20th Century Fox to be happy with it. Now, what I really like about Matthew Vaughn, and also his co-writer we worked with on Kick-Ass as well, called Jane Goldman, they managed to bring their sensibility to an X-Men film. Now, while it isn't out and out a Matthew Vaughn film, there are moments in this scattered throughout that just make it feel that way. He really manages to inject his sense of humour and his sensibilities in directing action into this film, and made it a very rewarding watch. The best points of this movie are the fact that it's set in the 1960s. I believe it's 62, and it's set against the Cuban Missile Crisis, and how that was actually brought about by an evil mutant agenda, which I won't go too much into. But it was also shot like a 60s movie. This looks and feels, especially the first half of the film with Magneto, this looks and feels like a 60s thriller, like a 60s Bond movie, one of the Sean Connery Bond movies, and it's just so well done. It's very classically shot. You feel like watching a classic espionage thriller, but it's an X-Men movie, and I really appreciated that. And once you get into kind of the final act of the film and all the action starts to kick off, it becomes, you know, just your normal X-Men movie. But for the most part, they really managed to bring that 60s sensibility to the film, and even in terms of some of the special effects are more practical than CG. and just look better. And it really does. The first half of this movie I thought was absolutely fantastic. All the actors are brilliant in it, and you also get a couple of cameos from old X-Men favourites, which I won't spoil if you haven't seen the film, but a couple of old X-Men characters do pop up for cameos in this, which I appreciated. But that brings me on to one of my minor niggles with the film, is that there are a few too many nods to the other X-Men movies. The most, one of which I actually noticed made people in the cinema cringe, that nobody really liked, was James McAvoy saying, "I'm going to start losing my hair soon," you know, and I didn't really need that, but most of the nods to the previous films I thought fitted in rather well. Now, as I said, the practical effects shots look really good in this, but another problem I kind of had with it was that for some of the shots, especially the CGI action scenes, they feel unfinished. They feel like they could have done, and not just the CGI, but also some of the editing. It feels like it could have done with one more round of editing, one more layer of polish, if you will. It kind of felt unfinished, and I thought, like, maybe that's just in my head, maybe I'm imagining that, but then I read online, after thinking that it turns out Matthew Vaughn had to kind of make and release this in less than a year, and it was kind of rushed into production for 20th Century Fox to get it released, so it's no wonder it feels unfinished. But considering, you know, the time restrictions that Matthew Vaughn had, he really has performed a miracle almost. You know, it's such a good film considering how rushed it was, and it had all the odds stacked against it. You know, it featured characters that, you know, we aren't as familiar with. You know, there is no Wolverine. You know, we've got Magneto and Professor X, but we've also got a host of other mutants that we don't know unless you've read the books. And it's been rushed. I don't think the budget was as big as the other X-Men films. And you've also got 20th Century Fox's stigma after X-Men Origins Wolverine to work through, but Matthew Vaughn has managed to pull off essentially a fantastic X-Men movie. All in all, I think that X-Men First Class is a return to form for the X-Men franchise. I really like the first two. I have a lot of time for the third one. I wasn't as hard on the third one as a lot of people were. I actually really quite enjoyed it. X-Men Origins Wolverine is terrible. There's no two ways about it. That is one of the dumbest, stupid action movies I think I've ever seen, and it's just, there's barely any redeeming qualities. This film, though, is a return to form, and while it fits comfortably into Bryan Singer's universe he created back with the first two movies, Matthew Vaughn brings his own style to it. You know that this isn't somebody doing a Bryan Singer impression. This is somebody putting their own mark on this franchise, and it's really well done. And now that Darren Aronofsky's dropped out of directing The Wolverine, I kind of like to see Matthew Vaughn do it, but hey, that's just me. I really enjoyed this film, and for anybody having doubts after seeing X-Men 3 and Wolverine, give this a chance, because I think you will be impressed. It manages to bring something new to the franchise while also giving you what you enjoyed and loved about the original films. So it's well worth checking out. I highly recommend it. And, you know, thank God that Matthew Vaughn has come in and saved this franchise from obscurity. So go see X-Men First Class. It's really good.